Shalom, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, and welcome to a special outreach update from Jerusalem, Israel. As the weather in Israel is very hot now this summer, physically, the power of the Holy Spirit is heating up the nation of Israel. The gospel is going forth. Genesis chapter 22, verse 2. Then God said, "Take your son, your only son, whom you love, Isaac's, and go to the region of Moriah. Sacrifice there a burnt offering on a mountain I will show you." As believers in Yeshua, Jesus God, we understand that it's a prophetic picture of Yeshua the Messiah, who died on the cross for our sins, rose on the third day, and by his blood, if we repent and believe, we have full redemption of sins. But for a Jew in Israel, it's an impossible concept to grasp, because most Jews read the Bible under rabbinic interpretations and are blinded to this truth. We were sharing the message of the sacrifice all through Yerushalayim, Jerusalem. Many were in shock when we finally got them to the Word of God without rabbinic interpretations and allowed the power of the Holy Spirit to open their eyes. As the Messiah of Israel Ministries team was praying, I began to share this message everywhere. An IDF soldier was walking by and overheard this. He turned to me and asked, "What are you talking to the people about sacrifices?" He was a religious IDF soldier. I asked him what his name was. He said, "Gil." I introduced myself and told him with love and compassion, "I'm just sharing what the Bible says." Gil turned to me and said, "The Bible talks about animal sacrifices, not about human beings." I turned the Bible to the book of Genesis chapter 22 and read verses 9 and 10 with Gil. When they reached the place God had told him about, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. He bound his son Isaac and laid him on the altar on top of the wood. Then he reached out his hand and took the knife to slay his son. We then read Genesis 22, verses 11 and 12. But the angel of the Lord called out to him from heaven, "Abraham, Abraham." "Here I am," he replied. "Do not lay a hand on the boy," he said. "Do not do anything to him. Now I know that you fear God, because you have not withheld from me your son, your only son." I asked Gil, "Is this talking about sacrificing an animal, or did God ask Abraham to sacrifice his son Isaac's?" Gil was puzzled. He said, "Yes, but God stopped him." I asked Gil, "Do you know why God stopped him?" Gil said, "When we study this in rabbinic school, yeshiva, we're told it's a high level. It can only be reached in the Gemara. I haven't reached that level yet." This is one of the enemy's tools to get the Jews out of the written word of God, so they'll be blinded and they won't see that Yeshua, Jesus, is the Messiah. Yeshua is God. Only the power of the Holy Spirit can open their eyes to the truth. Romans chapter 10, verse 17. So faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. I asked Gil, "Do you want to know the truth of what this Bible verse means?" Gil said, "Yes, but I didn't reach that level yet." I turned the Bible to the book of Yoev. Job chapter 42, verse 5. "My ears had heard of you, but now my eyes have seen you." I told Gil, "Your ears have heard the truth, but your eyes have not seen it yet. There's a veil. Only the power of the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit, can let you see the truth." This Bible verse here in Job 42, 5 is talking about spiritual seeing. Gil asked, "What is the foreshadow of this Bible verse? I want to know." It was incredible. It was supernatural. The power of the Holy Spirit was working on Gil. I told Gil, God was only testing Abraham. It was a foreshadow of the Messiah that would come, die on the cross on a tree for our sins, and rise on a third day. And by his blood, we have full redemption of sins and eternal life. I turned the Bible to the book of Tehillim, Psalms 2:7, and read together with Gil. "I will proclaim the decree spoken to me by the Lord. You are my son. Today I have become your father." This is what it's speaking about. The eternal sacrifice once and for all. The lamb without blemish. Gita then turned to me and asked, "Where does it say in the Bible verse that they mentioned lamb?" I turned the Bible to Genesis 22, verses 7 and 8, and read together with Gil. Isaac spoke up and said to his father, "Father." "Yes, my son," Abraham replied. "The fire and the wood are here. Isaac said, but where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Abraham answered, God himself will provide the lamb for the burnt offering, my son. And the two of them went on together, and God did provide the lamb, Yeshua, the Messiah, once and for all. At that moment, Gil was speechless. He said, I need to get to my army base. I need to go. I told Gil, it's good that you're going to the army base, but there is an eternal army, the army of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Yeshua. Gil became defensive and said, if this was so true, this concept, then rabbis would believe in it, and no rabbi believes in it. I then turned to Gil and asked him, have you ever heard of Arav Yitzchak Kaduri, Rabbi Yitzchak Kaduri? He said, of course, everybody knows who Kaduri is. What does Kaduri have to do with this? I said, Rabbi Yitzchak Kaduri believed that Yeshua is the Messiah. He understood that the story of Abraham is pointing to the tree, to the cross. Impossible, Gil said. I pulled out the book, The Rabbi, The Secret Message, and the Identity of the Messiah, and began to read with Gil. When Gil saw the book, he was fascinated. He asked, who wrote this book? Was it Kaduri or his grandson Yosef? I said, the Kaduri family did not write the book, but there is a revelation in the book that Rabbi Yitzchak Kaduri wrote by himself. Gil demanded to see the revelation of Kaduri. He was drawn to the book like a magnet. Praise Yeshua. We read many pages in the book of how to decode the note that Arav Yitzchak Kaduri left, Rabbi Yitzchak Kaduri. When we decoded the note together, it spelled Yehoshua or Yeshua. How can this be? Gil answered. Maybe Kaduri didn't leave this note. I said, we have forensic evidence that this is Rabbi Kaduri's handwriting. It was put on his website. They have been doing everything they can to hide this truth from the nation of Israel and from the world. I told Gil, man cannot hide God's truth. Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 14. For God will bring every deed into judgment, including every hidden thing, whether it is good or evil. The rabbis have been trying to suppress this truth, but God's truth will continue forever and evermore. And he used the most venerated rabbi in the history of Israel, Harav Yitzchak Kaduri, Rabbi Yitzchak Kaduri, to reveal that Yeshua, Jesus, is the Messiah. Yeshua is God. Gil completely forgot about time. He moved from time to the supernatural. He was now fascinated. We looked at many pages, at the book, The Rabbi, The Secret Message, and The Identity of the Messiah. He looked at the note of Rabbi Yitzchak Kaduri over and over again, and he couldn't believe his own eyes. He kept on going back to page 53 in the book and reading the note over and over again in Hebrew, not believing his own eyes. We then studied the Word of God together. Gil also received a copy of the book, The Rabbi, The Secret Message, and The Identity of the Messiah. We pray that his eyes would be open to see that Yeshua, Jesus, is God. One thing is certain, Gil and the many that heard the gospel this day will never be the same again. And for this we give all the glory to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Jesus Yeshua. Isaiah chapter 62, verse 1. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not remain quiet, till her vindication shines out like the dawn, her salvation like a blazing torch. And in Hebrew, for Zion's sake, I will not remain silent. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not remain quiet, till her vindication shines out like the dawn, her Yeshua like a blazing torch. Let's continue to stand together as the one new man, Ephesians 2:15. Bring the gospel back to Jerusalem and go home. Until next time, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, sending you blessings from Jerusalem, Israel, in the mighty name of Al Yehuda, the line of the tribe of Judah, Jesus Yeshua. Amen.
Sharon has died, aged 8. station. We are with one of Rabbi Kaduri's disciples.
We lost Yashvia.